What is a tractor?
Why should I say don't worry, be happy?
The first answer is, I don't know. Aw, shucks, I don't know.
To tell the truth, I've been worried from the start.
You move into that second level, and then you arrive at this sort of swarming theory cosmic debris land with lots of the philosophies drifting around about why you're doing what you're doing, where are you going, what's happening in life, why are we here, who's feeding the homeless.
Honey, you know as well as me, we got trouble with the capital T.
And you can wander around in that whole philosophical thing of thinking too much about what you're trying to do. You move down to the third level, and you're getting close to where the tractors are. We spend a lot of our time trying to let go of that, trying to quit thinking, trying to turn the brain off so we can get the piano part right on the record, or even writing the song, keep it from being so deep, so philosophical, so my music, and just, writing about the way life is. Then you get to that fourth level where you just be. You be the thing instead of trying to be the thing. And the funny thing is that fourth level is about the same as the first one. Aw, shucks, I don't know. The tractors is something that visually is for everybody conjures up something. If it's just a tractor in the field, but it has to do with working America and roots and where we all came from and working folks as opposed to the big city things.
Country rock is an easy thing to grab and say, but I don't know if that's really it. It's somewhere in there, rockabilly, country rock, guys gathering around the one microphone, somewhere from there to modern day rock and roll country. You name it, I'll take it.
The first country music I heard was, as a small child, and it was Hank Williams and Lefty Frizzell and Hank Snow and all those guys,
I was influenced by the great blues masters. That's what I'm trying to bring to the tractors, and I think that's what Bob Wills had in it. It had the great blues. He was a great blues fan. Listen to all the great blues players of his time. You can hear it in all his stuff.
To me, what I hear in it is it's working man's music to me,
That's our childhood music, so that's going to be a very big part of us.
So as you get older and you've gone through the whole mismatch of music and the type you like and stuff, and you get a chance to go that far back into your musical roots, it just strikes a nerve with you. It just kind of goes right up your spine and your skin,
For me, it goes back to 3 years old of Hank Williams records and Bob Wills records, of those what seemed like giant 78 records to me, and trying to get them on that little hole and play those records and just, not having any idea what those words meant. But it captured me then, and then Elvis a year or two later comes out and just slayed me. And there's those times, and I think there's times for everybody when music changed their life.
I think there's a lot about the past and the past of the music business that we all still like, that we'd like to see the music business sort of go back to a little bit.
Those hillbilly guys didn't know they were making hillbilly music or country music. They were just making music.
There's part of us that want to hold out for that thing that we like and keep it there and keep it in people's faces and, keep trying to get people to come back to that.
The music of the tractors is the sum of a lot of influences. And what I bring to it is my style is a New Orleans style. The geographical thing of Tulsa is that the Texas influence of the Charles Brown type music and the New Orleans influence and then the whole Delta blues influence.
It's that R&B mixed with country flavor that does it. That whole Tulsa shuffle becomes a thing. Instead of chuck, 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 de-dunk, de-dunk, de-dunk. Chill Wills said it best. He said, out here in Oklahoma, we have a peculiar kind of a rhythm. Did you ever see the cowhand riding the range, riding the horse? Dum-dum, 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 dum-dum.
coming from L.A. to Tulsa, I thought, boy, this is going to be great. There's going to be all this country music, and I'm going to get in. We're going to have steel guitars and fiddles, and boy, we're really going to do this up thing in the Okie country style, you know. And I walk into this joint here called the Magician's Theater, and they're playing B.B. King and Freddie King and all this blues stuff, and everybody's going wild, you know. And it sounded just like the L.A. guys, you know. And I says, you know, what's the dang deal here?
There's been a lot of musicians come out of Tulsa that have influenced each coast, in Nashville and Memphis and everywhere else you can name. You know, there's always been a piece of that in there somewhere. And I think it's just, you know, maybe a bit selfish of me to say that, but, you know, I think everybody else tries to play like us.
It's just like the weather, why it changes so much. Everything converges on Tulsa. We're this middle point where the, you know, the things from the north come in and the things from the south come in, and it mixes together and makes tornadoes. That's the music. I mean, it's just coming from everywhere.
She said her name was Emergency and asked to see my gun. Said her telephone number was 911. Got Brother Jimmy on the TV, killer on the stereo. Said if you want to get it, you got to let it go. She got the boogie, woogie, woogie spread all over the place. You got to stack through the ceiling, got to stick it in your face. You know my baby likes to rock it like it boogie, woogie.
Looking around, saying, what do we do now? Well, I always wanted to be in the music business. Do I get in or out? And we made those first few demos and sent them to Dubois.
He sent me a bio, and the first line of the bio was, I was never a cowboy. I was a farmer. And he started talking about growing up in Oklahoma and Glencoe, Oklahoma, and all this. And I was just enchanted by what he was doing.
So he sent some money for tape to make some real demos was the plan.
Well, actually, after I sent the money, I didn't hear anything for a long time. And it wasn't a large amount of money, so I wasn't laying awake nights worrying about it, but I kind of just put it in the back of my mind and thought, well, maybe I've been hoodwinked here and lost a little money back to the motherland in Oklahoma.
It was a long time in coming, and I think he'd given up on the whole deal. But, you know, we made sure it was right. And at some point, I decided to sort of set Tim Dubois up and try to knock him over.
And all of a sudden, one day in the mail, shows up this blue tube and stamped all over the outside of it. It's like a little mailing tube with a rubber stamp. It says, warning, the tractors are coming. So I open it up, roll it out, and it's a map that has Tulsa and Nashville on it and this little hand-drawn tractor coming towards Nashville. Day two, I get another one. You know, I open it up, and there's the tractors a little further along, and these kept coming for like 4 days. And on the fifth day, why, in came a shoebox. I opened it up, and there was a DAT tape and a cassette and a cast iron tractor, a John Deere green miniature tractor. And also included was a tractor's owner's manual. And I opened it up and looked. There were tracking sheets in there. There was all kinds of information. I remember dropping the tape in the machine, and the first thing I heard was Tulsa Shuffle. And I was hooked immediately.
He called me and basically said, hey, you win the game. It is a big game. It's a serious game, but you can't lose your sense of humor. And I set him up and pushed him over. He was easy, and he knew he was falling. End of thought.
Oh, dang it. Full woods right on fire. That's right.
Well, it was Leon Russell. He's the one that changed it from a church to a studio. The building was made in 1932, and it was the Evangelical United Brethren Church to do what we do and create that sculpting effect. it's probably the Tulsa School of Recording as opposed to Nashville or Hollywood, the Leon J.J. Cale School of Recording, where it's instead of the ensemble being there, which is the records we like the best, there's a sculpting process that you can do where you get all these sounds and you start shifting them into something. Where if there's enough things going on and you start to shape it, it makes one sound, just like in the old days, which is the records that we like, again, especially the guys here in the band, that the Bob Wills days, or back to, you know, Benny Goodman days, or, you know, 30s records, when recording began, where there was one microphone and the levels and the sounds, everything was gotten from moving people around, people playing louder and softer, and everybody played as an ensemble. So we don't necessarily have the luxury of that making records anymore, because it's a thing you have to get on the radio beside whoever's the current star. And they're making records in the factory approach, and it's a great method. And they turn out perfect record after perfect record after perfect record. So we'd like to be able to make this old-fashioned thing that is musical and sculpted that can live alongside that modern thing.
Baby likes to rock it like a boogie-woogie choo-choo train.
Ballroom. It's history in Oklahoma right here. I mean, trying to explain what Bob Wills means to somebody or how the influences work. It's like asking the truck driver how he learned to drive a truck, you know? Ask Bob.
Ask Bob. He's right there.
Bob?
He's looking good.
He's looking good. He's smiling.
Forehead's a little funky, but the rest of him looking good.
He's got that BG smile.
Everybody says this. I mean, I wasn't here. Best stuff was done right here because KVOO did the live broadcast from here. And it was that thing of happening right now that maybe we don't have in the record business anymore. It's like immediate. They were just having a band. They're having a good time having a band, creating. And
They swing,
yeah. There's so many of those nights where they had to get him dressed and get him on and trying to put his boots on the shark. It went on for about 30 minutes. He had his socks and his boots. He couldn't get it on, but he's too drunk to tell him.
All I could say was, shock!
Yeah, that was my only Bob Wills story.
That's it. Okay, out of film.
Boom, boom, boom.
I will sing the song. When it comes to the smutty part, then you stop me. All right?
Amen.
Why should I say, don't worry?
I believe in worrying to some extent. You know, things are falling apart. Everybody's going through that stress of whether you're on the poor level, on the poor side of town, or whether you're out in the $100,000 a year in double income families. Everybody's sitting around, how am I gonna make that mortgage payment? It might be the $2,000 mortgage payment, it might be the $200 mortgage payment. But I think everybody in America, and maybe the world, but America's right now going through a period of extreme stress, the same feelings from everybody. How are we gonna pay those bills? And so that stuck with me a long time, of everything seems to be falling apart, but you gotta work through it.
Every time I think you really, truly love me, you do your number on my head and on my heart. You've always got a reason to tell me no, too early, too late, too fast, too slow. Everything we got is falling apart. Why should I say,
this record is a record filled with noises that were first takes, knee-jerk reactions. We roll the tape, and then we leave it. Yeah, there's mistakes, but try to massage it into something that people can identify with. And I think that if it's, you know, its imperfections are what they will identify with. We're not living in a perfect world. You know, everything is falling apart. It doesn't mean depression. It's what the blues are about. Those blues songs are the happiest feeling party song things you can get, and they're all about depressing subjects, but it has an uplifting thing. I mean, that's what the Tractors are about. It's but party music, dance music. People should be able to get up and dance, and we're all in the same boat. That's the thing to identify with. And then let's have a good time. Let's be happy, you know, and move on. And let's be happy. Don't worry. Be happy.
I want to get people interested in what it is we allowing our elected people to do and get away with. Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you.
Come on. I think I may need to hear the bass.
You've been home in 30 days.
Did you do that?
30 days.
Stevie.
This is my Uncle Elmer's house. This is the place that all the relatives gathered. Nobody in the family really played instruments of any kind. I mean, there's lots of stories in Arkansas and Oklahoma of all the uncles played music, but it wasn't that, but they loved music, and they went to those Bob Wills dances, and there were records galore that I listened to up there and sometimes tossed out of that window, which makes me shudder right now. But I was dead serious about it all, and I was the guy practicing in front of the mirror trying to be Elvis, and my dad sticking me up in front of the relatives and having me sing the latest Elvis song and my best Elvis. And I thought I was doing it. I've heard the tapes since then. My dad also got me started on that. You know, he had a Webcord tape recorder about this big that he used in sales training. So if you want to lay the blame, you know, he's the one that stuck me up in front of that microphone and rolled the tape and said, you know, let's hear Heartbreak Hotel. Let's hear Wake Up Little Susie. Let's hear some of those songs. Bang a chanka, bang a chanka on the guitar and just singing like an idiot. But, so, you know, at best they thought I was cute. I suppose I was cute, but not me. I was dead serious. You know, that's where it started for me. That's why I remember this house fondly. That's why I thought we ought to come down here and see that, there's a lot of debate about what's country music, what is country music, but I know that I'm from this farm right here. I'm from the country. And for me, that makes anything I do be country music.
And this sound the way it goes.